My name is James Francis. I will be your facilitator for today's Brainstorm Roundtable, co-sponsored by Altron Systems Integration. And we will be talking about building IT strategy around applications and workloads. So frankly, those are interchangeable often. How do we build an IT strategy that connects to business outcomes and yet makes the best use of workload and application placement? 100% cloud, 100% on-premise strategy is very limited, only for specific companies. Most companies will need to go hybrid, but lift and shift strategies don't work that well. And then if we want to add to the complication, yes, we should all go hybrid, but now the world is very, very literate because we're all going to have different combinations on how we put these systems together. So building strategy around this is very taxing, and especially when we start filtering in what the business needs.
It's more of a systemic approach that one needs to take. So you need to look at business drivers, cloud economics, data, people in your culture. You need to look at a new operating model. There are security considerations. Your applications and your infrastructure need to be designed differently. And then I think that also gives us the ability to have a more agile kind of IT environment.
I do believe as well that business will come to you and say that I don't care where my application resides, if it's in a multi-cloud hybrid environment, as long as I've got consistent layers of security, governance, user experience, and application delivery. And I believe that that is where we need to aim to move towards, that you do what you're good at and I'll do what I'm good at. And if I do not meet your requirements, then we can have another discussion.
I think it has been a prediction in the R&D that 40% of applications will only be able to go into the cloud.
What's the intended outcome? And often that's where the sort of misalignment comes between where business is and where IT is.
It's all about partnership with business. Most of the time you realize that business will say we need ABCD, but when you get there, you find that that is not what they require. They need something else.
There will always be a solution that fits you, but what is really the need for the organization? And once you are able to establish what the need for the organization is, are you able to actually educate the organization and educate your workforce, educate your directors, educate everyone about being productive with, you know, the new tools that you have or the new applications that you brought in?
If you do the security elements right and you're agile and you have proper governance in place constantly and you live and breathe security, something like integrating security into projects early on so that you don't have to go back later after you've transitioned, then it'll cost you more to work backwards and try and get the security right.
The way that everything changed overnight, companies had to adopt to a work from home strategy. Then they had to realign to assist with user experience and customer experience to support that. So projects were placed on hold. Now we are reimagining ourselves as the landscapes have changed, and with that we are going to a new normal where to stay relevant in our customers, how do we do that? So for our customers, it's just the same story. How do they remain relevant in the eyes of their customer?
Cloud is the number one enabler for digital transformation. Technologies like cloud and AI and IoT, that almost kind of was left to the back burner. And I think we need to understand that's actually the end goal, is digital transformation. All these different things are taken into account, and how do you get the components of the bigger system to work together from a systemic systems engineering perspective?
And with that said, thank you for joining us today and enjoy the rest of your week. Thank you and goodbye.